First move, computer 2. Draw card. Begin duel. Computer 2, mana charge. Mana release. Summon.
Round 4 kicks off with Dwarf Snipers. I'm gonna cover this left lane.
Computer 1, draw card. Mana charge. Mana release.
That's gonna be answered by more Dwarf Snipers. This seems like a carbon copy of how the last game started. I'm sure last week it was two creatures of similar, just summoned next to each other. Just being buddies at the start. Well, there goes the Earth Fields in the Earth deck, so anything that happens now is just random. Ah, out comes Frost Guards. Onto their home field. And they will gain perfect dodge if a fire creature attacks them. But for now, they're just going to tickle the dwarves.
Computer 1, draw card. Mana charge. Mana release. Summon.
Single cost to the fire space. A relentless skeleton. Behold my power. Well, they're definitely the target.
Unlocked. Computer 2, draw card. Mana charge. Mana release. Summon.
More Frost Guards, you say? They shall answer. They only need one damage here. And they provide it. Good lads.
Mana charge.
Down goes the skeletons.
Computer 1.
No answer from Computer 1, so this is... Sorry, I jumped ahead of myself there.
Summon.
We did have an answer, and that answer is of course a battle buggy. Why wouldn't it be?
Attack.
Chooses to attack at range, so it gains plus one. And it is also hitting... Oh, sorry, it's not. I'm getting tongue-tied and I'm confusing myself. Do damage to the Frost Guard. Because it was attacked at range. Need to think before I even say anything. Clapper and Marauders! Greetings.
Attack.
We're gonna have a bit of an exchange of fire here. Attack Dwarf Snipers, one damage, and they're not going to like that. So, we see your one damage, and we match you. Dwarves are not too bothered about it. Clapper and Marauders are on one health.
Computer one.
Nice early check for Computer 2, however it's not going to last. Those guys are going to die.
Mana release. Attack.
They're gonna die, right? Paying into the battle buggy. It's not attacking at range, it's attacking the ones just in front of it, so one damage to them.
Mana release. Summon.
And one cost into the center. There's our swordsman. Ah, he's keeping the Clavron Marauders alive for a future turn. And instead taking down these Frost Guards, who now, because they're on 2 health can be finished off.
No one will defeat me.
Mana charge.
Those soldiers do have blind spots on all sides apart from the front, though, so...
Draw card.
And they've only got one health, so any damage is going to kill them now.
Mana release. Summon.
Out comes Behemoth. Half the time it will transform. Will it do so now?
Attack.
No, it won't, so it stays as a pupper. Can only attack in front of itself and only hit for one. But that's enough. It gained an extra attack from hitting a blind spot, but it wasn't needed.
Mana charge. Check.
Check once again for computer 2. Computer 1 needs to kill. There's still the Marauders.
Mana release. Summon.
And Flailmonger will happily deal with that. Two fields in front of the Flailmonger have +2 to their summoning cost. It's also not very careful about its attack and it hits everything. So, yeah. Little bit of friendly fire.
Mana charge.
Down goes the Marauder, and one damage to the Battle Buggy.
Computer 2.
Downright fucking heresy. Could be shot on sight.
Mana charge. Mana release. Attack.
Dwarf snipers don't like what they've seen. They're gonna open fire. So one damage though.
Mana release. Summon.
Flame Guard recruit. Normally doesn't deal any damage whatsoever, however, if one target is on a water field, it will gain +2. Now the Frost Guards that they are about to attack gain perfect dodge if they are attacked by a fire creature, so they manage to dodge the friendly fire.
Mana charge.
Very nice play there, and the 2 damage takes down the Battle Buggy. Heresy of the highest order.
Computer 1, draw card.
Computer 2 is into check. Computer 1 must kill. You've got to go for the Flame Guards.
Summon.
Now comes Navogus Warrior. Unlike last week, they did not cost 5 to get out. They will attack in 2 directions at once. So 2 damage is going 2 ways here. Bonus damage on the Flame Guard recruit because they hit a blind spot. And 2 damage to the Behemoth. Behemoth won't like it. And the Pupper bites them back. 1 for its fallen comrade.
Mana charge.
Down goes the recruit.
Computer 2. Draw card. Mana charge. Mana release. Attack.
Snipers are going to continue tickling this Flailmonger. I mean, it is down to 2 now. But it is manageable now.
Summon.
As our swordsman will finish them off. Did have to pay 2 extra to get them out though, because they summoned in front of Flailmonger. However, they only cost... Do they only cost 1? They only cost 1 to get out, so he paid 3 to get rid of it. You could argue it's not worth it, but... To open up the field a bit more and not have to worry about the +2, it's probably the best.
Computer 1.
Computer 2 goes into check. Computer 1 must kill. It's got the swordsman to kill, so... Oh, no.
Mana release.
I thought he was going to activate those snipers and just kill the swordsman, but no, we're going after the frost guards. Rotated them and shot, so one damage to them. They're not going to like that, so a bit of counter-attack. And then I assume there's a summon coming to kill
summon.
Something. Ah, Flame Guard recruit returns. However, this one is not friendly to the Frost Guards. Plus two for them. But Perfect Dodge still goes off because it's being attacked by a fire creature. So why did that two damage go through?
Mana charge.
Did I miss something? Frost Guards gain perfect dodge when attacked by fire creatures. So why did that go through?
Draw card. Mana charge. Mana release.
Was it because they were hitting a side? Oh,
summon.
Could have been. I'm not sure. Anyway, they're dead. Two answers with Navogas Warriors. We're going to take great offense to those Flame Guard recruits, and they die. Poor Flame Guard recruits haven't survived much in this game, but they have managed to get kills on each time they've come out, so...
Mana charge.
I guess they're worth it. That's going to put Computer 2 into check. Computer 1 must kill. Two creatures rather low.
Mana charge. Mana release.
Rotates the snipers back to their original facing and will do what I thought he was going to do last time. Which is execute the swordsman. Bonus damage there because the swordsmen have blind spots on all sides except the front.
Mana charge.
Not that it needed it. And keeps itself in the game, can still choose to summon,
Computer two.
And chooses not to. So Computer 2 summoning
charge.
Back into check.
Computer one.
Or maybe not, chooses to bank the mana. Computer 1
mana
with a chance
charge.
To catch up.
Mana release.
And out comes Fishers of Goli, flip the elemental field to its opposite side. So this fire field is going to become a water field. Very bad news for the pupper sat on top of it. It loses 4 health. 2 because it's no longer stood on fire, so it doesn't get its health bonus, and 2 more health because it's stood on the opposite element of water, as it is a fire creature.
Computer 2, draw card. Mana charge.
But no summon there.
Mana release. Summon.
Here comes Behemoth Terraformer.
Attack.
Our only other Byleth. It's going to charge into those skeletons and deal 1 damage.
Mana charge.
But it also swapped the field that it stood on with the target field.
Computer one.
So the fire field that was in the center has now moved
mana
underneath
charge.
The terraformer.
Mana release. Mana release.
And those snipers have
attack.
Been rotated once again, getting a lot of use out of these guys, but paying a lot into them. Close range shot, still 1 damage.
Mana release. Summon.
Out comes Flame Guard Recruit. Again, no damage, but plus 2 if the target is on water. Which is exactly where those Navogas Warriors are. So, smack. And down you go. Ah, indeed.
Mana charge. Computer 2. Draw card. Mana charge. Mana release. Summon.
6 mana for computer 2. 3 goes into this.
A battering ram.
The battering ram provides 1 defense for adjacent allies. And now it's going to cleave this whole top row. Damn. 2 damage for the dwarves just in front of it. Because it was hitting a blind spot, but also deals 1 damage. Friendly fire to the other dwarves.
Mana charge. Mana release.
Really keeping the numbers down in this game. There are more dwarf snipers. Greetings. Those creatures cannot dodge.
Attack.
And takes aim at the side of a battering ram.
Computer 2. Draw card. Mana charge. Mana release. Summon.
Out comes a battle buggy. About time. +1 protection because it's next to the battering ram. Decoy goes off. Again, I'm not sure what the decoy means. I'm going to have to read up. So I can't explain it. It is attacking the Flame Guard recruit who are at range. So +1 damage. And it is hitting the sides of the Flame Guard recruit, so extra damage again. 3 damage, you're dead.
Check
for computer 2. Those are some healthy boys.
Mana charge.
We need some range or just heavy hitting shit.
Summon.
As far as heavy hitting. Got tongue tied. As far as heavy hitting shit is concerned,
attack.
He hits the hardest. Gains +2 damage. And he is going to assassinate dwarves. I was wondering, he gains +2 attack because he adds 1 to his attack for each undead creature in his graveyard. And because he killed a creature, his other bonus goes off, which is to bring back a creature from his graveyard, which is not an ultra rare. And he chose the Vezar Swordsman.
Computer 2, draw card. Mana charge. Mana release.
Computer 2 choosing to summon back into check once again. Flame Lizard Commander gains quickness, so we'll always go first, and he hits for 3, so these snipers are very, very, very deadest. Also a really strong position now, because Computer 1 spent all his mana on Vamos just to kill one card, and now he has 3 mana for the next turn. And all the creatures out are quite healthy. And the only one that's not is hidden in a corner. So this needs to be a belter of a card.
Discard.
This is going to be Festival of Earth, so he has discarded Vezar Swordsman and Nivogus Warrior. The Festival of Earth is played, discard 2 creatures, at least 1 must be an Earth creature. During your opponent's next turn, add 3 to the summoning costs of creatures on non-Earth fields.
Mana release.
And then he chooses to summon onto the remaining Earth fields. A good job he did that, otherwise that spell wouldn't have had effect the next turn. If Computer 1 chose to summon that space.
Attack.
As our swordsmen, they are attacking the battle buggy. The battle buggy does have plus one protection because it's next to the battering ram. So the two damage is reduced to one. But it doesn't like being hit. I'm going to ram you in the face. How dare you?
Computer 2.
And Computer 2 now gets to try and summon. It will have to pay extra if it tries to summon anything. And it can't do. So, that spell is now removed. Festival of Earth is now not in effect, but Computer 1 gets to go again. That's another big boy cost. Out comes Behemoth Terraformer. Is obviously going to go for the battle buggy because of the swap that's about to occur. Oh dear. It rams the battle buggy, deals no damage because of the protection, but then it will swap the field that it stood on with the field that the buggy stood on. Buggy is now stood on the opposite element of wood, so it loses 2 health, and then further 2 because it's no longer stood on Earth. Vamos claims a victim, and so brings back a dwarf sniper. Probably the only card that could have kept him in the game, realistically, considering the health of the creatures that it was fighting. 6 health for Computer 2. And we're going to have a Terraformer versus Terraformer battle. So just 1 damage.
Mana release.
The fields underneath them did swap, but because they're Terraformers, they don't care. And a Relentless Skeleton into the corner for good measure. Just to sit there.
Computer
check.
One. Draw card.
So the target is either the battering ram at the top or the skeletons.
Summon.
And Cloudrunner Marauder will choose to take out the skeletons.
Attack.
And down they go, and suddenly after a few turns of being 4 cards up versus Vamos, it's now heavily in Computer 1's favour. And Computer 1 brought back a battle buggy. If there's any card that's got to be brought back, it's got to be a battle buggy. Computer 1 in check, Computer 2 needs to kill 2 creatures that it could potentially go for here with 2 health. Chooses to use Fishers of Goli, so that's going to get rid of the Verzhar Swordsman at the top. Put the elemental field to its opposite side, so this earth field will become fire. So the swordsmen are going to lose their plus 2 health bonus. I would personally now summon into the water space in the bottom right.
Mana release. Summon.
This is war! Kill them all!
Okay.
Attack.
We're summoning Novogris Warriors. They're going to attack Vamos. Not going to kill him, but that's going to piss him off. But it will make him, of course, attack. Plus 1 attack for every undead creature in his graveyard, so he's hitting for plus 3. That's a big ouch. When everything surrounding it dies, so worth it. Very much worth it in the end. 3 cost creature to attack Vamos to make him kill 2 of his own. Very strong. And Vamos brought back a dwarf sniper because he did kill that Novogris warrior.
loses the Terraformer, and he loses the Cloudrunner Marauder. And he took 2 damage himself, so yeah, that was 3 cost really well spent.
Mana charge. Mana release.
Lose your field morph. Oh, sorry, field bond. The target creature has field morph. So now the creature that it, the field that it stood on now basically acts as whatever element the creature is.
Mana release. Summon.
So that field now turns into an earth field. Which means that now he's stood on his home element, his basic attack has changed to just in front of him. So Vamos is not as lethal anymore. And out comes a battle buggy. Juting the battering ram at range, and it takes it out because of the plus one damage.
Mana charge.
So the protection is now lost to adjacent allies. And Vamos gets to trigger. And he brings back a Vezar Swordsman.
Computer 2. Draw card. Mana charge. Mana release. Summon.
The Rogus Sinbearer. It is quite rare I actually see this, so I am really, really not sure what it does.
Mana charge.
If it's on an earth field, each time another allied creature is destroyed, you gain 1 mana for each undead creature in your graveyard. A great way to get a lot of mana back. Repeat 1 answers with Dwarf Sniper. While Navogas Simber is on a non-earth field, all other allied creatures gain plus 1 protection and destroy him if he is on a wood field.
Computer 2, draw card. Mana charge.
Snipers deal 1 damage there mana to release. The Sinbearer.
Summon.
Becomes Relentless Skeleton. Create a little box, who obviously gains protection from the Sinbearer. Effectively has 2 health. Check for computer 2. Computer 1 must kill. Skeletons are the target. You need to deal at least 2 damage to kill them. D's command. Choose 1 allied creature you can that you can activate to attack. The target creature attacks without paying the activation cost. So he's going to attack these skeletons because he can only attack 1 target.
Mana charge.
This has worked out a bit cheaper because the cost to activate Vamos is 5 and the cost of D's command is 3. You just save 2 on the attack there. Vamos obviously activates again because he killed something and he gets a Relentless Skeleton back.
Discard.
Computer 1 has reached 8 cards, so he has to discard a card. That will be... Is that a Lament for Claire Will?
Computer 2. Draw card.
It is, so Lament for Claire Will is gone. Computer 1.
Mana release.
Computer 2 summoning back into check. Vanguard Recruit comes out. Protection from the Sinbearer.
Attack.
One of its targets is on water. So it gains plus 2 attack. 2 for you. And 2 for you. It doesn't kill anything, but the battle buggy will not like that, and so will counter. However, that protection from the Sinbearer saves it.
Check. Computer 1.
Computer 2 inject Computer 1 must kill. Again.
Mana release. Attack.
Need quite a bit of damage output here to kill something. Snipers are going to continue to attack the Sim Bearer.
Mana release.
And the final mana. It's going to be a Vezar Swordsman.
Attack.
They are hitting for two, and they are hitting a blind spot, so this is three damage. One of which was, of course, blocked by the protection from the Sim Bearer, so the other two went through.
Mana charge. Search graveyard.
Thomas claims another victim. And brings back another Vezar Swordsman. Reached his hand limit, so we'll have to now discard a card and gets rid of a Relentless Skeleton.
Check. Computer 2. Draw card. Mana charge.
Check for Computer 1. Three creatures on 1 health, so multiple options here to get rid of. Uses a Dwarf Battle Buggy. Which will lose 2 health immediately because it is summoned onto the opposite element.
Attack.
Of wood. It's attacking its opponent at range, so plus 1 damage. And it kills a battle buggy. That is heresy, but it's done by a battle buggy, so I guess it balances out a little bit. That battle buggy also has protection, remember, so it has effectively 2 health.
Mana release. Summon.
So 2 damage needed to take it out. And a resurrected battle buggy is exactly what can do that.
Attack.
It attacks back. Plus 1 range. Plus 1 attack, sorry, because it's attacking at range. Heresy has been balanced completely.
Mana charge. Search graveyard.
Thomas claims another card from the graveyard. And it's the battle buggy that just died. Interesting. You see your battle buggy and bring back ours.
Discard. Graveyard.
And then it had to get rid of a card, which is a Vezar Swordsman, because it reached hand limit.
Check. Computer 2. Draw card.
The only problem with Vamus, he makes you reach your hand
mana
limit
charge.
A lot.
Mana release.
But you can just get rid of a card that you've literally just brought back with Vamus, so it does balance itself out in a way. Terraform are going to activate and attack the dwarves, killing them. And making the field swap. So now there is an Earth field available for Computer 2 to summon on.
Mana release.
Which it will take advantage of, obviously.
Summon.
And bring out its own Dwarf Snipers, which will have a health bonus. And protection. Don't forget the protection.
Attack.
Attack the battle buggy. Heresy! Thy name is Dwarf Sniper. Plus 1 attack for the battle buggy. Stacking at range. But the sniper has protection, so that plus 1 is negated. Just 1 damage goes through. Very strong position for Computer 2 now. You need a lot of damage to kill anything.
Mana release. Summon.
Here comes Dwarf Sniper. Loses 2 health because it's summoned on the opposite element of wood.
Attack.
Going to attack the rear of this Flame Lizard Commander, so blind spot is in effect. But it has protection, so the 2 damage is negated to 1.
Check
for computer 1. Computer 2 needs to summon. That's all it needs to do.
Mana release.
And not die in the process.
Attack.
Chooses to get rid of the swordsman first. So 2 damage to the swordsman. The fields will swap. There's a water field in the centre. Can computer 2 summon?
Computer
it
one.
Can't. That's why it went for the attack.
Mana charge. Mana release.
So computer 1 going to get to go again and chooses to attack the Flame Lizard Commander again. This is going to be a further damage. Again, because the bonus damage from the blind spot is negated by protection. So he's down to a 2.
Summon.
The resurrected battle buggy will seek to finish off the Flame Lizard Commander. The battle buggy loses 2 health because it's summoned onto opposite element of wood. Gains plus 1 attack because it's attacking at range, and it will gain a further plus 1 because it's attacking a blind spot. The 1 damage is negated by the protection, the other 2 goes through and kills the commander.
Mana charge. Search graveyard.
Thanos claims another from the graveyard. Brings back a sniper. And then must discard a card because he's reached his hand limit, so that sniper is gone straight away.
Check. Computer 2.
Check for computer 1. Computer 2 must kill.
Mana charge. Mana release. Summon.
Now comes Vamos. Attack changes. Plus 1. Protection.
Attack.
3 targets, one of them is an ally, so its ally is going to die. But it gets to take down the 2 enemies. So because it's this late in the game, and because computer 1 will overdraw first, it's worth it. And now Computer 2's Vamos gets to start playing resurrection spells and brings back a dwarf sniper. Also worth noting that the field on the center left is now no longer earth because the field bomb from earlier is now removed. And Vamos also brings back a dwarf battle buggy. So that field has now turned from earth back to water. It was only going to stay as earth as long as Vamos stayed alive. Hand limit has been reached, so Lament for Claire Will has been discarded.
Computer 1, draw card.
Computer 1 has only a few turns left before it overdraws, so it needs to win, and soon. But I don't think it basically needs all creatures that come out now to stay out. Flame Lizard Commander now has access to an exposed Sinbearer. Sinbearer doesn't have protection, even though it provides it. So the 3 damage from this commander is going to go through. And down goes the Sinbearer. So protection for all allied creatures is removed.
Mana charge.
And Computer 1 gains advantage.
Computer 2, draw card.
But like I say, every creature now for Computer 1 needs to stay alive.
Mana release.
Problem is, one of its creatures is only on one health. But probably won't live long. Thamus in the center gains illusion field bond. So that field is now effectively Earth as long as he's alive. So plus 2 health for him. His attack changes.
Mana release.
It can only attack one target at a time.
Summon.
Dwarf Sniper comes out and he's going to kill these ones in the bottom left.
Attack. Mana charge. Search graveyard.
Thamus claims another. And back comes a swordsman.
Computer one. Draw card. Mana charge. Mana release. Summon.
Yeah, I think Computer 2 has won this. I don't think Computer 1 can just get enough creatures out now. It's going to overdraw. Behemoth does transform. It attacks in three directions at once and gains plus 2 attack.
Attack.
And he's just going to roast these guys alive. Down they go.
Mana charge. Computer 2. Draw card. Mana charge. Discard. Graveyard.
You two discards a Vezar Swordsman. Paramatic Holy Feast. Discard a creature to gain plus 2 mana. Doesn't really need to do it, but okay.
Mana release. Attack.
Ah, it's pumping into Thamus. It's making sure everything goes. Thamus with plus 5 attack now because there's 5 undead creatures in the graveyard. This is gonna hurt. Oh boy. Oh, goodbye, Commander. That was a 6 health Commander, by the way. He just one-shot it for laugh. Love it. And claims another from the graveyard. The Sinbearer is back. Oh boy. How much is the Sinbearer to get out? Is a 5 cost, right, so he's not coming back, but that's interesting to bring it back. There's our swordsman. Gonna take offense at the battle buggy. Just...
This is it.
Oh, how dare you?
No one will leave me.
So unbelievably rude.
Mana charge. Search graveyard.
Thamus claims another. Another Vezar Swordsman.
Computer one.
And now we enter Computer One's last turn.
Mana charge. Mana release. Summon.
Now comes Flame Novice, 50% of the time on each attack, he will gain plus 1.
Attack.
Not that he needs it, because his target only has 1 health. And it doesn't occur this time. But again, it doesn't matter.
Another death.
Beat me.
Mana charge. Computer 2. Draw card. Mana charge. Mana release. Summon.
This is Computer 2's last turn. And he also brings out a Flame Novice. It's not going to attack anything, it's just going to stand there. GG, Computer 1 overdraws.
Computer 1. Computer 2 wins by library defeat.